Hey guys, I just woke up, and you probably can hear it because of the shower. I look so good. I'm gonna look better in like 5 minutes. But today is the day that I'm going to be induced. It's 5 o'clock in the morning, and I have to be there by 7. But I live like 30 minutes away, so yeah. So yeah, I'm about to take a shower, get dressed, to get ready, and I'll be back.
See, when I start recording, you get irritated. So, did you record yourself, dude?
No, I haven't.
Oh,
look at my chin.
In my body, in my body.
I don't have a chin anymore.
I'm about to say,
what you did. Just straight neck. Oh, drop my phone. I dare you to drop my phone. And you got it upside down.
Your wrist was swollen.
This one?
Oh, that one.
You see?
Oh, I see the difference. So it's me, as of course, mommy, looking angry and mean.
Personally,
look
ahead for it, so
you
don't look like
I look
bald.
Because I got a big forehead.
We both do.
I didn't realize my forehead was that big until now. Until I got a haircut.
It's not because he cut off your hair.
And then, playing basketball in the sun. I got two different shades.
Yeah, your skin color is a different color right here. Like, all around your hairline.
No, like, you can actually see, like, right there.
So, I've been here since 7 o'clock. And they put in the balloon to stretch out my cervix, and it got to 2 centimeters. And I think they took that out at like 1 or 2. What time did they take that out, that balloon? What time did they take that balloon out? Like 2 o'clock. But, yeah. So I had that in the front from 8 to 2. And I got 2 centimeters. And now I'm on the Pitocin to get to start my contractions and stuff. And that's about it. I'm eating a popsicle because I can't eat anything now that I'm on the Pitocin. But yeah. Mom's over there. My grandma right there. But yeah, hopefully RJ come out tonight. He probably won't, but hopefully he do. Alright, bye.
Man, I look old. The boy looks sexy though too. Alright, Robbie. Let me stop calling you Robbie because you're probably embarrassed. Like, if you see this at 18, 25, don't matter. You probably be embarrassed. Like, oh my God, why is my dad calling me Robbie? But RJL just pulled up to the hospital. As you can see, I'm in the parking lot. Got your car seat. Can't wait for you to be in it. If you wonder why the granola bar is in there, it's actually your grandma's. Or your great grandma. Miss Grandma Ivy. Yeah. But yeah, I'm here. About to walk in the building. See your mom. So talk to you shortly. I'm so old. I'm so old. I can't even stop it right now. Wow. Wow. I haven't been a parent for like 2 seconds yet. I'm already getting old. I already can't use technology. I'm like my mom now. Ah, great. Ah, darn it. How do you stop this thing? No, for real. Come on. All right, look. My phone is messed up. I was about to cuss. My phone is messed up, okay? So bear with me. Still going. Wow, this is embarrassing. Oh God, come on. So, Robbie, it is July 20th. It's Friday, July 20th, 2018. I'm 25. It's like 8:38 in the morning. Just got off of work. Went home, take a shower and stuff. On my way to the hospital to see your mom. They are inducing the labor. So, just wanted to show you what it was. Or everything I was going through, everything your mom was going through leading up to your birth. And to all these years, this is where it all began, son. I love you.
Here's where I found out I had to get a C-section. I was pretty upset, but I knew everything was going to be all right. And he was born 5 pounds, 7 ounces. And the reason they had to do C-section is because his heart rate was getting low, and so they had to put me on oxygen to help that. And yeah, they also had to do a C-section because my cervix wasn't dilating enough, so he kept pushing against my cervix, and his head was starting to get swole from pressing against it so much. So they were like, we have to take him out now because his breathing's off and his head's starting to get swollen. So they took him out, and he came out perfect as can be and a healthy little baby boy. And we love him every day. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of the video.
When I first laid eyes on you, when I heard your heartbeat too, oh, I never knew I could witness an angel so beautiful. From the very moment you arrived, I felt something new inside. I developed a love that was so unconditional. And I promise to give you everything that I have. There's not a dream in this world you can't accomplish or grasp. I will cross any ocean before I let you land. Just hold on to mama's hand and never let go. Just hold on to mama's hand and never let it go. I'll never let nobody hurt you, give you the world, cause you deserve it. Teach you how to treat a woman, let you know you're gonna be something great.
too. Oh, I never knew I could witness an angel so beautiful.